Alright, so since the Carthaginians aren't coming for us right away, and we now have a decent garrison, let's send my army up here. Yes, perfect. And we're going to retake Sengunten. We're going to build a few rams, and, wow, they have ballistas. Some allied Republican cohorts. I think I should be able to grind them down pretty well. What kind of walls do they have? Wooden palisade? Oh yeah, no, I'm definitely going to be taking care of them next turn. Show you a trait that is really cool. If you go down here, it will say... Nope, maybe not there. I found it on a couple governors, and it's pretty great. Something about the... Yeah, the lands are prospering. So, it leads to less unrest, better trading, better tax collection, and that goes for, I think, most of the governors get this trait. Yeah, they do. It's pretty great. Oh, this guy's in a dale now. Very, very cool. Okay, in Gadir, we have now offered them, we made them an allied state, so that's going to improve things. We're going to eventually want to recruit our own men here as well. So let's start with the Roman Oppidum, and then it's going to be the next tier, and then I'm going to go with Rural Community Control and try to get that population up as well. Actually, I'm going to have Gadir, Tinky is all of a sudden exposed. Huh. Let's send my fleet down here a little bit. Let's take a little sneaky spy on things. Huh. I don't see anything. Well, before I was gonna send Publius Cornelius Scipio here up along to Carthago Nova so he can help with an attack in this, you know, central part of Iberia. But now I'm almost tempted to make a strike for Tingi, even if I don't keep it. Huh. Think. What should I do? What should I do? I have a choice with taking a risk and taking down another Carthaginian town, even if only temporary. Or sending my best general. Well, reinforcements will be coming soon. Plus, I can recruit my own guys here in Carthago Nova, too. Let's see how many men I can take out. Maybe that should be the other question. Because Tingi has a wooden palisade, so I'm going to have to wait there for at least a turn. Wait, maybe I can have him build a watchtower. Man, I don't see anything. Not in the immediate vicinity. Let's see what I can take out. Can I take out them? Yes. Them and them? Yes. Population order is pretty good. How about some slingers? You better believe it. My veteran triarii? Oh yeah. How about the rest of my slingers? Yep. Screw it. We're gonna go for it. Yep, we're gonna try to take and loot Katingi. Sounds good to me. Alright, building time. Yay. We're going to leave Rome for now. Let's deal with more important territories, like, for example, Arminium. I built all my population growth measures here, so that will be fine. Right now, I want to focus on upping my growth and upping my colonization. So, for example, I'm looking for buildings that will allow me, say, more rural community control, or, obviously, population growth level, just the first tier. I don't need to go to the second tier just yet. No need to go nuts. So, for example, here in Agrica, we'll have our population growth measures. Also here in Amasana, in Lilybaum, in Illyria, and whatnot. Now, Region already has its population growth measures, but it still doesn't have this colonization. And I was reading this, and it says that, you know, control over the area has strengthened and more Romans want to occupy the territory. So this is really infrastructure is what this building represents. So we're going to up the infrastructure as well before we, you know, deal with anything else. So where were we? That was Region. Genoa. How are we doing here in Genoa? Pretty happy. You're waiting for more people. Okay, fair enough, fair enough. So we can build some temples for you. Maybe a shrine to Juno. Yeah, let's build a shrine. I have yet to do that. So, Mercury, Ceres, and Juno. Queen of Heaven and the wife of the sister of Jupiter. Makes sense. Now, this is grain and fertility, which is great, and this is trade and profit, but as a good Roman, I think Juno takes more precedence than Ceres or Mercury right now. So, although I will actually take a little hit to my income bonus, I'll up my happiness, and, well, things will just be a little bit more authentic as this video game can be. Crotona, same thing. We want to focus on the infrastructure. Let's, you know, work on that. And plus, it will give me a really good chance to recruit better units rather than some piddly little garrison. These kind of levy troops. Most of everything that I wanted to build is built. So now let's once again focus on glorious Rome. We finished the river ports. So what do we want to do with Rome? Do we want to focus on our economy? Do we want to focus on our military strength? You know, all my other territories, I'm focusing on growth and economy, and I need to have some sort of military strength somewhere. So let's quickly look at Rome itself, and look at its type of barracks. Where does it recruit her units? Is it... no, it's not there. Great Forum, no. This is the cultural building. Campus Martius? Oh, okay, yes it is. So I don't think I can go any bigger. Trigger by building Imperial. Oh, neat. A province of the Romans have gained great stature. So I don't think I can actually build anything. No, it's already provincial. I've built as high as I can. So militarily wise, this is it for Rome herself until, you know, the Marian reforms show up, which makes sense. Instead, let's focus on a dockyard then and get some naval military presence. I have the money, after all. Arminium. You already have your growth measures, I think. Yeah, you should. So now we could diversify your crops, which would also, you know, help. Romans weren't really, actually it said right here, Romans, since a lot of long military campaigns, farmers had to go back to disrepair farms, things would go bankrupt, you know, nobles would buy them, so right now in this period of Rome, they're not known as great farmers, they're known as great fighters. So that could help. We could up the law for the sake of that. We can up our temple, first aid center. We just up the taxes for crying out loud. I mean, sure, we'll take a hit to our public order, but I mean, our public order is pretty gosh darn well. Maybe we can annex this place. Oh, it's already annexed. Alright. Wait a second. Yeah, it is already annexed. I do recall doing that. I don't see my huge tax bonus, though. You promised me a huge tax bonus, you gosh darn thing. But yeah, I'm pretty sure I did annex them, didn't I? Last turn. This is the same thing. Huh, that's weird. Maybe it's just not having the penalty. Well, see, that, yeah, this one says tax income bonus 40%. That's weird. I wonder why some regions... Let's look at Capua here. Yeah, same thing. Hmm. Maybe it's not a big enough city? Maybe it grows with the city? I don't know. Hmm. Well, we'll leave it right now. But that's kind of... odd. Oh well, whatever. Enough of my rambling. Let's make a decision here, for crying out loud. Well, because I'm not happy with the whole not getting, you know, the obvious building bonus, and they'll just take hit of, what, 5%? Whatever. We're gonna institute a communal tribute. There we go. I hope they enjoy it. Alright, in Dyrrachium, now that it's somewhat secure and it will have support from the rest of Italy, we'll select the regional focus for Dyrrachium. So we're not done here in Carthago Nova. I'm going to recruit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8 more men here. Let's see here. We have 4 cavalry, so let's make it 5 cavalry. I can even have my own general over here, but might as well use generals I'm not using. Let's have 6 slingers, and let's round up the rest with spearmen. Now, the population isn't great, but I won't recruit any more here in Carthago Nova. I'll have a full stack of native Iberians, and that will do. And once again, I'll be focusing on growth measures, and if necessary, I can lower the taxes one more. You know what? I'm making enough money. I think I am going to do that. Let's really recover the loss of troops there. Oh, and I can even retrain that one unit. That's nice. Alright, so I ended the turn, and here is my repayment for such risk. This army crept out from somewhere. I have absolutely no idea where. They must have maybe were hiding in the woods or something. Anyway, they've come to face my own men. The odds are 4-3, because I have Publius the Badass here. But I am, and the numbers of men are pretty close to even. So... I'll see you on the battle map. Alright, so here's the setup. The Carthaginians had the setup there, and I've been able to take advantage of this hill right here. So of course I have my... I saw that they had slingers, so I have my own slingers in a loose formation. I have my simple layout of my infantry, and my triarii in the back, and my cavalry on one wing, and my general close to my men. Old Scipio here might have to be doing some fighting though, so let's start the battle. And there they are, and there are the reinforcements. So I'm going to set up right along the tip of this hill right here. So we're going to send my slingers right there. Actually, we can ungroup them and bring the rest of this particular group right here. I think we'll do quite nicely. We'll run them since they will be resting. And yes, they are going to turn to face me, which is great. They have actually not as much cavalry as I thought they did. So hopefully my slingers, with their significant height advantage and my ability to fight downhill, will become great. But I'll continue recording once we get a little bit closer. It looks like they are trying to maneuver around somehow. Alright, so they did maneuver around here as if to meet the rest of their compatriots, but looks like most of them are coming up the hill, and this will now give me a chance for my slingers to get into position as soon as possible. Okay. Soon they'll find a target and start raining some stones down upon the enemy. Now, I don't want to take advantage of this. Let's bring my men ready to strike there. Their cavalry's on the on my right, so I'm going to send my own right there. My triarii on that one end. Okay, now let's pick out targets. We can go for the Biliarch Slingers, but I think they're going to actually go for their Numidian Cavalry. Well, these fellows...
Yeah.
Now they all go for their Biliarch Slingers. I'm actually going to send this cavalry around on the left here to harass their slingers once my infantry is fixed. Speaking of my infantry, however, it's time for them to get into position right here. And these guys can actually use the woods to their advantage right here. They'll run. Actually, everyone here will run. Even you guys. Time for my slingers to withdraw. These ones will withdraw right around here. And these guys will withdraw right around here. Okay, let's give them a quick throw of our pila before we charge downhill at them. Let's bring up my general to help them out. Where's my triarii? There they are. Okay. There we go. Now, let's deal with their slingers. These guys are going to take off of skirmish and fire at will, because there's no point otherwise. These Balearics, though, they'll still go after that Numidian cavalry. Yep, good. They still have a height advantage. Good, good, good. We're going to spring my slingers around here, actually, though. Now we're going to put them in a tighter formation. Alright, so these slingers have now been routed. So let's go for the... Let's go for these ones. Yeah, let's push these guys up this way. Bring these guys around. These guys no longer need to be in tight formation. They can get all the way up here. I'm tempted. No, we're going to keep my triarii in reserve. I have to learn not to use my reserves nearly as much as I would like. Now their Numidians have gotten stuck in the fight, which is fantastic news. So we're going to take a run at their Balearics, while these guys here are going to sling right into the backs of these early Libyan spearmen. So now we're going to bring up my triarii just a little bit. Just a little bit. We're not going to get them fixed just yet, because we have these Numidians that we have to worry about. Okay, we'll wait for them to break. How are we doing here? So that's helping quite a bit. Good. Let's just pause here for a second. They're not broken just yet. But we're going to bring these guys a little bit even further down, because if they make a run for my... These Numidians make a run for these guys, I want to bring my triarii around to help them out. And since... my triarii are there. We'll allow my slingers to do their thing. Now these slingers, no, they don't have range there. Besides, they're too busy beating the crap out of these fellows there. I think I've pretty much, yeah, they've broken now. Oh, and here's the Numidian cavalry. Let's try to pinch them in. Very interesting. Okay, well then, let's... Oh, my triarii. I know what to do with these guys. They're going to be slinging at these fellows here. Now, do I run my triarii up, or do I swing them around? Let's swing them around. These guys are going to go after them. These guys, too, are going to go after them. In fact, we're going to retreat these guys to the top of this hill and have my cavalry here kind of guard them. What have they done? Wow, I don't know what they're doing. But I'm going to just keep my triarii right here. These slingers are now going to pelt this light infantry. I've almost won here on the left. There we go. Okay, let's deal with them. Triarii, let's bring them down there as well. Sorry, I shouldn't have had these guys charge. Now, hopefully, my missile cav might be able to hold down these Numidians in time for them to show up. Oh! Carthaginian general. Let's have our generals meet each other. Nice downhill charge. I have them outnumbered. Let's hope that fight goes well. Speaking of fights going well, Numidian cavalry did manage to deal. In fact, they're going to pursue them all the way to the rest of these slingers. This triarii now is not really needed. These slingers can do their thing here. This fight is still going like crazy. For some reason it says the Libyans should be winning, even though they're outnumbered by a bunch. But let's just do that. That seems to be going well. So then let's get rid of this light infantry with my triarii. Yeah, there we go. Alright, so that's good. So I want to take a look at this fight, actually. Let's see that general. Meet his maker. There he goes. Gorgeous. Alright, so let's have our slingers continue to do that. Let's swing around our general. And we're going to actually have this general come around this far side. The enemy army is in flight. There they go. Now they're broken there. Okay. You guys can stop running. You guys can stop firing. Have they broken here? Yes. So you guys can also stop firing. There they go. Alright, it looks like it's mostly cleanup, so I'll see you at the results screen. So, that was a clear victory with 1,254 kills, and it looks like about 269 losses. Okay, so we've taken Tingi, and we're going to actually enslave their populace. And we're going to try ourselves a little once the turn ends here. Okay. Great. We're going to try ourselves something a little sneaky. Let's see if I can get my men out of here. Will I be able to make a break for Gadir? You better believe I can. So we're going to head back to Gadir, lick our wounds. We're going to merge up what we have. Actually, we're going to quickly see if I can't recruit any more mercs. Nope, I can't. So that's all Gadir will get. But we're going to go nuts here in Tingi, because we know they're going to take it, so we might as well have a very high taxation. And let's destroy everything we possibly can. Completely raise it to the ground. So let's destroy their barracks. Destroy their market. Destroy their shrines. Destroy their more shrines. Get rid of any taxes that they would have to pay. Demolish their wine, olive oil, trade and production. And rake up a good little chunk of money. And leave them with barely anything. That way, we've at least landed some sort of economic blow to the Carthaginians, since I don't think we'll be taking Tingi anytime soon, considering we have to deal with all of this. Oh my goodness, look what we have on our back step. Well, isn't that interesting? But if we can take St. Gunton and solidify what we have here, and maybe even march over some reinforcements once this city's taken. Because I could take it. Okay, so we're going to just maintain that siege, because I want to do some other things before I take Saguntum. But I think things are good, because if I can take Saguntum in this turn, use it to fortify, they'll besiege, I'll send in reinforcements, we'll crush that army, then sweep over here, take the remnants out, and take this last Carthaginian town. I think that will work quite nicely. Oh, look, and that stupid agent that kept on trying to get to Carthago Nova has finally been caught and executed. That's good, that was getting annoying. Oh, wonderful, and it looks like Agrica can now expand into the next level of city. So, that's fantastic. Now, I'm not too sure exactly what to do with this fleet yet. And here's the decision point. I can send it up to Emporia. Now, they do have some siege equipment, so they are going to take it this turn. However, I could take it back the following turn. And then my north here, after dealing with what's going on here, that would be great. Or I can say, screw it, they can have Emporia. It wasn't really all that profitable, it wasn't really all that important. And instead, focus here and send my army here. This way we can crush these guys quickly, plus I can send reinforcements down to Tingi as soon as possible. In addition, if the Galaci, these Iberians, want to get even more aggressive and expand down south, I'll have a good position to do so. I don't like the idea of losing territories, though, frankly, but man, Emporia wasn't really doing me much, although I did invest quite a bit in it, didn't I? And they didn't send a lot. And I do have this kind of handled. I'm a little worried about this. But forces from Carthago Nova could come by and help out. No, I don't like losing territory. Screw it. I'll recapture it and then send my forces back down south. I think I have things handled here, especially with... Yeah, I think I have things handled.